People from all over the world come to this building to check it out. It's a pretty cool spot, you know? It's a lot of unity, you know? And it's kind of, you know, open. Awesome, amazing artists, good and shitty. I don't know how long it's gonna last, but 538 has been fun while it lasted. And it's still here, so let's see how long it lasts. This is Optimal NYC. Yeah. Peace.
We don't pick the art. If it's good enough, it's all good enough. Whatever you can do it here.
So a lot of times, DJs and music and art, it gives people reassurance. It gives people positive reinforcement to say, you know what I'm doing is right. You know, because you have a lot of times, the media portrays your thoughts as wrong. They tell you, oh, you're thinking is wrong. But art allows you to express your right thoughts.
We called it the Novecento because the idea was to drive from Munich down to Como on a bike like this, where you need Autobahn, you need wind and weather protection, you want to go very small alpine roads, and you also want to go to the Como with a very small Italian roadside.
A través de la música se puede expresar, casi no, se puede expresar todo. Es el lenguaje universal. ¡Tapa la playa! Mi nombre es Rubén Cuesta Palomo, alias Candyman. Vivo en Cristina y Calle 11, reparto Mariana La Torre, colindando con Altamira.
Justement, la cuisine, il n'y a pas de limite. On peut créer, on peut innover n'importe quand on veut. Un petit homard cuit avec des feuilles de vigne sous vide à basse température, avec une petite vinaigrette relevée au piment d'Espelette. Voilà, c'est des idées, des impressions. C'est juste du bonheur, en fait, la cuisine.
J'ai le plaisir de vous présenter aujourd'hui un espace assez extraordinaire parce que c'est une exclusivité MSC Croisière qui s'appelle le Yacht Club. Et le Yacht Club, en fait, c'est une zone du navire qui est très haut de gamme et qui a la particularité d'accueillir moins de 200 passagers sur les plus de 4000 passagers, mais dans un espace absolument VIP et très, très haut de gamme.
You know, I spent a lot of years traveling, being a professional skater, traveling around the world, competing, doing shows, demos, competitions, and I learned so much. You know, I didn't have a lot of opportunity when I was growing up here in New York, and when I turned 11 years old, I started skating, and it just opened up an entire world for me that I had never known. I mean, I'd read it in books, you know, but you'd never get the sense of what it really is until you get to see it for yourself, and skating did that for me.